Good afternoon. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Jasmine Davis. I am a graduate student at Louisiana State University, Shreveport, and this is my final project presentation titled Improving Reading Comprehension Through Small Group Instruction. So a little bit of background about my study. We're all teachers, and we know that it's our job to provide a quality education for our students, especially our struggling students. That's something that's a goal for us in every day. And there's been a lot of research recently about best practices in literacy instruction, which has increased due to the population of English language learners in the United States. I have a couple of graphics I want to show you. The first one is a map of ELL density throughout the United States. So this was from 2012-2013. You can see the states that have the darkest shade of teal actually have the highest density of the L population. But what's interesting to notice, our state here in North Carolina is in the middle. So we are getting an influx of L's in our state as well, and we see that in our school. Our L population is extremely high. This next chart just breaks down the top 15 states that have the highest L student population. North Carolina is actually 8th on the list, and this was from 5 years ago, but it shows that about 7% of the entire enrollment within the state was L population. So you can imagine how much that has increased since then. So with that in mind, that led me to want to do something that was meaningful and impactful for L students. Learning gaps exist between L students and their same age non-English language learner peers. They have learning gaps in the areas of fluency, vocabulary, reading comprehension, and word decoding skills. And with the rise of RTI, schools are moving away from just providing good quality instruction to now also providing research-based interventions to help close those gaps between students that are struggling and students that are on grade level. And as a result, teachers have begun to use multimodal instructional methods and a variety of reading strategies to help close those gaps for L students and non-L students. Now I just want to take a few minutes to go over some research that I used in my study that has direct bearings to it. This first study here examined the relationship between reading fluency and reading comprehension for English language learners. This study showed that L students have a lower proficiency in vocabulary and reading comprehension compared to non-L students, and this lack of fluency negatively affects their reading comprehension. Another study examined the likelihood of language behaviors occurring within instructional groupings. So this is the different ways that we might teach our students, whether it's whole group, small group, one-on-one, them working with a peer, or them receiving no instruction at all and just working independently, the likelihood that they would have a language behavior. So participating out, raising their hand, sharing. The findings showed that in a small group setting or in a one-to-one setting, their language production had a higher probability of occurring. This study here was a longitudinal study that examined the effects of small group instruction with Spanish-speaking L students who were at risk of reading difficulty. They had an intervention that lasted over 60 days for 30 minutes per day, and the results were showing that students increased their reading achievement from having this intervention from their pre-test to post-test scores. Another study that was similar, it examined the effects of providing phonological interventions to preschoolers. This intervention lasted from 28 to 36 lessons, 3 to 4 times per week. The results from this study that focused on a specific targeted skill showed that the students increased their proficiency in that area. And the last two studies I want to note are these two, the Scholin from 2013. They provided literacy interventions as a part of the RTI framework for 17 weeks using a commercially based intervention program called Read Naturally. In this program, students received comprehension quizzes, progress monitoring, regular feedback, and progress about how they were doing when they were interacting with their stories. The results showed that implementing this program was shown to be effective in increasing their proficiency with literacy. And finally, this study examined the effects of small group vocabulary instruction for at-risk kindergarten students. Participants were given a pre-test and a post-test in the areas of receptive vocabulary, reading vocabulary, decoding and spelling. And this result showed that students made significant gains immediately following the study, so that was after they took their post-test. Then they also followed these students up a year later. So once they had ended first grade, and they found that they were still showing high growth. So why are these studies important? These studies showed me that when students receive literacy instruction in a small group format on a targeted skill. It's shown to be effective and help close those achievement gaps that they're facing. So why did I feel the need for this study? As I mentioned earlier, I wanted to do something that was meaningful for me, and it was going to impact my own teaching. As teachers, we have a wide array of instructional methods and comprehension strategies that we use to meet the needs of our students. And there's many research studies out there in the world that examine what is the best way to reach these students. However, the data has been inconsistent and inconclusive. There's so much to choose from. So I wanted to do a study that was going to focus on a specific skill, a specific target. And also, with the increase of the L population rising, we need to find a way that we can meet these students' needs and close those gaps for them. So the purposes of my study, it will offer insight into specific needs of the growing population of English language learners in the United States. This study will add more data into an expanding research field regarding best practices for literacy. And the study will also measure the effectiveness of small group instruction as a tool for teachers. So my research question is this: how does small group instruction affect the reading comprehension of English language learners? It is my hypothesis that reading achievement will increase when students receive small group instruction. For this study, 63 participants participated from a single elementary school in North Carolina were categorized as English language learners, meaning that they currently receive ESL services from the school here, or they are being monitored for ESL, so they have not exited the program. The other 27% were categorized as non-English language learners. That means they have been our English proficient, they no longer really receive services, also, or they have never received ESL services during their schooling. And as we know, 100% of the students are qualifying for free and reduced lunch. The instruments that were used was a literacy pretest and post-test created by the researcher myself to use to measure their reading proficiency growth. Each test contained 10 multiple choice questions and 2 fictional reading passages that were aligned to the 4th grade Common Core State Standards for Literature. I chose these 4 standards because they were aligned with what the students were receiving instruction in during the first quarter of school. The study lasted for 5 weeks. The students were receiving whole group instruction and small group instruction during those 5 weeks, and the small group instruction was directly aligned to those 4 standards that I mentioned. The pretest was administered at the beginning of week 1 of the study, and the post-test was administered at the end of week 5. Assessments were scored by me and then uploaded into the Mastery Connect data tracker to measure their growth. And it was graded on a 10-point scale where 10 points was 100%, 9 points 90, so on and so forth. Statistical testing was used to compare means between the pretest and post-test scores to measure 4 gains. And I also tested for statistical significances from each of the students' pretest and post-test scores. I also broke the data down into the subcategories of English language learners and non-English language learners to see which group had higher growth, if any. So these were the results of my study. So the first test that I did was a paired samples t-test, and I looked at the mean scores for the entire population, and this showed that there was a significant increase from the pretest to post-test. You can see here on the chart, at the beginning, the mean score was 56.39. That increased to 63.11 over the course of the 5 weeks. The mean increase between scores was 6.72 points. I then compared means for the entire population sample, as well as English language learners and non-English language learners, to just examine their mean scores as well. Results showed that students that were categorized as English language learners had higher post-test scores than pre-test scores. You can see here on the chart, their scores went from 53.11 points to 62.39. That was a significant increase. The non-English language learners' mean score increased from 62.94 to 65 points. So once again, we are seeing gains in growth from the pre-test to post-test scores. I completed a paired samples t-test to evaluate for statistically significant differences between pre-test and post-test scores for just the English language learners. So that means taking student one's pretest score and measuring it to their post-test score and doing that for all of the students involved. Results of this test were also significant. The increase was from 53.11 points to 62.44. That was an increase of over 9 points. assessments for our English language learners during the 5-week study. And so this chart just explains that as well. And the final test was the same Pair Samples T test for the subcategory of non-English language learners. This test was not significant. There was not a significant increase from pretest to post-test scores. You can see here on the chart, their pretest was about 65.63. The post-test was 65 points. So that was the only group that didn't have a significant gain. So my study sought to test the effectiveness of small group instruction and how it affects reading comprehension for students. According to the result of my study, the mean scores of the students' post-test scores were significantly higher than their pre-test scores. And when I looked at the data specifically for our English language learners, their data also showed significant gains with their reading achievement after they received the literacy-based instructions proficiency increased. So this information allows me to accept my initial hypothesis. Reading instruction, when students receive small group instruction, their reading achievement will increase. So there's a couple of things that I believe led to the increases in scores, and I've kind of connected it here on the chart to what research says. So I'll start here for what influenced those results. Firstly, students receive instruction in a small group format. Their instruction was directly aligned to what they were receiving and being tested on daily in class. Students were also selected for the groups based on their non-mastery of skills on their weekly assessments. The remediation occurred in a small group format, and it was limited to 3 to 6 students per group. Students could successfully participate in the academic discourse and get in-the-moment feedback from their teachers. So how does that connect to literature? You can see here what research says. Students who receive early interventions in a targeted skill area are shown to be effective and achieve significant gains in their instruction. L students specifically need extra practice with their skills that are taught in whole group. Oftentimes they don't just get it the first time around from their teacher explaining it in class. They need some extra help with it. So by pulling these students into a small group and working on a specific skill that they were receiving that whole group instruction in and the small group instruction in, I believe that led to some significant gains. And also, the study here by Brooks and Thurston found that language behavior will increase with students in a small group format. So when they're pulled back to that small group setting of 3 to 6 students, they're more likely to participate. They will ask questions, they will share out, they won't be fearful to make mistakes, and they get that feedback. They know immediately how they're doing and how they need to improve. With the study, I also thought about what would be some limitations of the study and how future researchers might improve the study. One limitation I found was the varied instructional resources and small group instruction in each participating classroom. So the participants came from the language arts team on this 4th grade, but there was no guidelines as to what each teacher could use. The teachers had freedom in choosing what their interventions would be. Stricter guidelines for instructional resources might change the data in a future study. Also, I feel that the study had a short time span. 5 weeks seems like a long time, but a longer study, perhaps 12 weeks or even 18 weeks, might show more gains with students. Also, there was a mixed method instructional delivery. Students received both whole group and small group instruction, so there's no way really for the researcher to know which instructional method had greater bearing on the study. So a future study might have a control group versus a treatment group where one group receives only whole group, one group only receives small group instruction. And finally, the subcategory classification and small sample sizes of the non-L students could be a limitation. A future study might classify the students into more categories, such as students who are already on grade level and examine their growth. Students that are below grade level, how much did they increase? And also, my sample size for my non-Ls was only 27%. So the fact that they didn't make a statistical gain from pretest to post-test was a question that I had, but in a future study that has a higher population of non-L students might see different results. So, in conclusion, as educators seek to find instructional resources and teaching strategies to aid them in helping their students attain proficiency in literacy, implications from the study might provide a possible tactic. By allowing students to access their content area through short and length targeted small group instruction, students will be able to achieve a greater range of success. Small group instruction is a strategy that can be applied across all content areas to all subgroups of students. Specifically, providing the small group instruction to students that are struggling readers or English language learners is a way that teachers can improve their reading proficiency. So, any questions, comments you guys have?